Hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel. So glad to have you here. So today I'm going to be talking about the large number of store closings that are shutting down due to, I guess, the large amount of people who are choosing to shop online instead of actually going to stores. So if you are interested in knowing about what stores that are closing, then I suggest you watch this video. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so like I was saying, there is a large number of stores that I found that were going out of business, some larger retail stores. Some of the benefits of this for us, the consumer, would be that we can get items at a super discount rate. Sometimes items can go for 50, 70, even 90% off. And as far as flaws on this, the only flaw that I can really find on this is most of the time the items are non-returnable because they are going out of business. So whatever you decide to purchase, please make sure, if you can, just try it on, or make sure that you are 100% needing this product before you purchase it, because you may not be able to get your money back. So with that said and done, let's get started on these major retail stores that are going out of business. Now, the first store I found out about was Pier 1. And for those of you who are not familiar with what Pier 1 is, they are a furniture, home accessories type of store. They sell furniture, lamps, towels, and large variety of colors. It's a very high-class, nice place. They are said to close 450 stores by the end of 2020. So that is a plus. They haven't given the official date, but once, maybe if you have one in your area, you might be able to check them out to see what kind of sales they have going on and get a bit more information. The next store I saw was Papyrus, which is like a gift card shop. It gives me Hallmark vibes. They sell gift cards and things of that nature, and they plan to shut down all of their stores in USA and Canada. So if you have one near you, feel free to stop by to try to get an official date of when they are closing. So the closer the stores are to closing, the more the deal is. So maybe you want to wait a while, or maybe you just want to go now and try to get some deals. But yeah, that's the second store that I found that was going out of business. And next, or third, I should say, I found out that Gap will be shutting down 130 of their stores. And they're just simply going to merge with Old Navy. Gap and Old Navy are already the same, ran by the same people. I guess now they're just going to just convert them into one company. So if you have a Gap near you, like I said, I highly recommend it that you go check out to see what kind of sales they have going on. And next on the docket here is Walgreens. They are planning to close 200 of their stores in the U.S. And this is due to something called a cost cut program. They didn't really specify about it, but they are planning on closing 200 stores in the year 2020. Let's see what else we have here. We have Chico's, which is I don't really shop there that often, but I guess it's more like a dressier department store. They are planning to close 200 of their stores, and as well as 90 White House Black Market stores and 60 Soma's stores. I'm just gonna keep it real. I don't really shop there, but sometimes I tend to go into these type of stores that
even though I don't really shop there, just I will go in there because they are going out of business to see what kind of sale they do have going on. And you might just find something that you like, or, you know, a gift or something like that. So, next on the list, that will be Chico's, Soma, and White House Black Market. Let's see, what else do we have here? Forever 21. They are going to be closing about 178 of their stores here in 2020. I've been, I like going on shopping trips on weekends. I can find them where you get on a large bus and you go on like to a different state next to you or something. Like, I live in Indiana, so we used to go to Ohio or Kentucky or something like that to go to outlet malls. And I have been noticing a large number of Forever 21 stores that are going out of business. I have found some items like 50-60% off, such as blazers and things like that. So if you have a Forever 21 in your area, you might want to check to see if that particular one is going out of business, and, you know, see what you can find. Good luck to you. And let me see, all the rest of these are pretty much small stores. Macy's is going to be closing 125 stores. And that is pretty much it. These other stores, I'm not really familiar with what they are. But if you would like to know more, just feel free to leave a message or a comment down below and let me know that you're interested in this, and I can get down to the smaller stores. But I just wanted to give you a nice little start. You know, some of these places are closing like 200-300 stores, and like I said, Pier 1 is closing 450 stores. I didn't even know they had that many still open. So hopefully this video was helpful to you guys. I know I'm in the middle of trying to redecorate different rooms and such in my own house, so I will definitely be stopping by Pier 1, and I do like Forever 21, so I will definitely try to find one near me. So with all this said and done, peace and love, and until next time, I'll see you later.